the founder of the castle in Eddyville, Kentucky State Penitentiary, also known as the Castle of Cumberland, was a total piece of shit named Highland Bitten Lion. And Highland Bitten Lion's grandfather, by contrast, was a heroic Irish immigrant who fought as an American revolutionary in the War for Independence. And his name was Matthew Lyon. Okay, so let's start out with Matthew Lyon. Matthew Lyon was born July 14th, 1749, and he died August 1st, 1822. He was a printer, farmer, soldier, politician. He served as United States representative from both Vermont and Kentucky. Matthew Lyon attended school in Dublin, having been born in nearby County Wicklow, Ireland. So he's Irish, right? He's an Irish immigrant. So Matt Lyon moved to Arlington, Vermont in 1777. Matt Lyon represented Vermont in Congress from 1797 to 1801 and represented Kentucky from 1803 to 1811. His tenure in Congress was tumultuous. He brawled with one congressman, was jailed on charges for violating the Sedition Act, winning re-election to Congress from inside his jail cell. Matthew Lyon served during the Revolution, serving initially under Horatio Gates in upstate New York, and a version of events later circulated by his political opponents. Matthew Lyon reportedly cashiered for cowardice and was ordered to carry a wooden sword to represent his shame. In Matthew Lyon's version, his men and he were not being put to good use, and he asked to leave Gates' command and join the regiment commanded by Seth Warner. Matthew Lyon's conduct was vindicated by both Arthur St. Clair and James Wilkinson, which are actually kind of sketchy people, because Arthur St. Clair, he lost against the Miami and the Shawnee in the Ohio campaign under George Washington's presidency. And then you had James Wilkinson, who is famous for the Spanish conspiracy. That's when he tried to get Kentucky to become a colony of Spain in order to get control of the Mississippi River when it was deciding whether it wanted to become independent or part of the United States or part of the English crown or the French crown. Okay, so Matthew Lyon built and operated various kinds of mills, including one for the manufacture of paper. He established printing office in 1793 and published the Farmer's Library from 1793 through 1794. Is officially listed as being operated by his son, James Lyon. It was continued as the Fair Haven Gazette. Lyon was an unsuccessful candidate for election to the Second and Third Congresses and unsuccessfully contested the election of Israel Smith to the Fourth Congress. He was elected as a Democratic Republican to the Fifth and Sixth Congresses. He was not a candidate for renomination in 1800. Matthew Lyon had the distinction of being the first member to have an ethics violation charge filed against him when he was accused of gross indecency for spitting in Roger Griswold's face. Griswold, a congressman from Connecticut, had insulted Matthew Lyon, called him a scoundrel, which at the time was considered profanity. On January 30, 1798, Congress planned to have a meeting to remove William Blount of Tennessee from office. Griswold was trying to attract Lyon's attention, but Matthew Lyon was ignoring him on purpose since they belonged to opposing political parties. Matthew Lyon was a Democratic Republican and Griswold was a Federalist. Griswold finally lost his temper and insulted Matthew Lyon. Their clash started when Matthew Lyon began a congressional discussion by declaring himself willing to fight for the interest of the common man. Mockingly, Congressman Griswold asked if Matthew Lyon would be fighting with his wooden sword, a reference to Matthew Lyon's dismissal from Gates' command during the Revolution. Furious, Matthew Lyon spat on the congressman, earning himself the nickname the Spitting Lion. On February 15, 1798, Griswold retaliated by beating Matthew Lyon about the head with a wooden cane in view of the other representatives on the Senate floor. So he beats Matthew Lyon with a wooden cane in front of other representatives on the Senate floor. This is kind of similar to what they did to that radical Republican right before or after, during Lincoln's time. They beat the shit out of him for being for emancipation. So you have Griswold who beat him on the head with a wooden cane in view of everybody else, and then Matthew Lyon retreated to a fire pit and he defended himself with tongs until other congressmen broke up the fight. So one has a cane, the other one's got tongs, and they're sitting there just kind of duking it out, you know, with these weapons. Griswold had to be pulled by his legs to urge him to let go of Lyon. Although the Ethics Committee recommended censure, the House as a whole rejected the motion to censure him, having married the daughter of Governor Governor Crittenden, it is possible Lyon had too much influence to have been removed, though others argue it was because any actions taken against Lyon would have been pursued against Griswold. Lyon also has the distinction of being the only other person. It could be Chittington or Crittenden. I think it's Crittenden. They misspelled the R, the H, but Chittington? Crittenden. Okay. Matthew Lyon also has got the distinction of being the only person to be elected in Congress while in jail. On October 10th, 1798, Matthew Lyon was found guilty of sedition in violation of the Alien and Sedition Acts under John Adams, the second president, which prohibited malicious writing of the American government.
Yeah. North Point prison burning to the ground.
The planes are getting worse.
On the news, they've tried to get people to back down.
Yeah, you're right. They are getting worse, aren't they?
Yeah. They said that they said on the news that the police were like tear gassing them and stuff in there, but they won't spread or.
As a whole, or the House as a Congress or the President, so he wasn't allowed to criticize any of the government. Matthew Lyon was the first person to be put on trial for violating the acts on charges of criticizing Federalist President John Adams for his pretense of going to a doing a quasi-war with France. Matthew Lyon had launched his own newspaper, The Scourge of Aristocracy and Repository of Important Political Truth, when the Rutland Herald refused to publish his perceived radical work. On October 1st, Matthew Lyon printed this paper speaking of the unbounded thirst for ridiculous pomp, foolish adulation, and selfish avarice, greed, as well as Adams' corruption of religion to further his war aims. At the time, it was quite common for Federalists to cite religious reasons for going to war against France, as well as for silencing the opposition. Matthew Lyon had also, before the Alien and Sedition Acts had been passed, written a letter to one Alden Spooner, the publisher of the Vermont Journal. In this letter, which was written in response to perceived personal attacks from the journal, Matthew Lyon called the president bullying, and the Senate's response is stupid. Once the Alien and Sedition Acts were passed, the Federalists pushed for this letter to be printed in the Vermont Journal, adding charges to Matthew Lyon by subterfuge. One other charge included publishing letters written by the poet Joel Barlow, which Matthew Lyon had read at political rallies. These also were published prior to the acts. Matthew Lyon's defense was to be the unconstitutionality of the acts, as Jeffersonians saw these acts as violating the First Amendment to the Constitution. In Matthew Lyon's particular case, there was the aforementioned letters to Alden Spooner as well as to Barlow, which meant Lyon felt entitled to bring up the Constitution safeguards against ex post facto laws. The defense was not allowed. Matthew Lyon was sentenced to 4 months in a Virgin's jail cell, dimension 60-foot by 12-foot, used for felons, counterfeiters, thieves, and runaway slaves, ordered to pay a $1,000 fine and court cost, while Judge Patterson lamented being unable to give a harsher punishment. So Matthew Lyon is going to prison because he was against the quasi-war with France, and he spoke up against the pretenses for why John Adams was doing it, plus some of these other lesser stealing of other people's ideas. So he goes to jail in the 16-foot by 12-foot prison, and he has to pay $1,000 fines. $1,000 worth of funds. So a bit of resistance movement was created. The Green Mountain Boys even threatened to destroy the jail and might have done so if not for Matthew Lyon urging peaceful resistance while in jail. Lyon won election to the 6th Congress by nearly doubling the votes of his closest adversary, 4,500 to 2,500 upon his release. Matthew Lyon exclaimed, "I'm on my way to Philadelphia." In the election of 1800, Matthew Lyon cast a deciding vote for Jefferson after the election went to the House of Representatives because of an electoral tie. Matthew Lyon's trial, conviction, and incarceration boosted his status among the fledgling American Republican political elite as something as a free speech martyr. Matthew Lyon moved to Kentucky in 1801, settled in Livingston County, Kentucky, later Caldwell County, and now Lyon County. He became a member of the Kentucky House of Representatives in 1802, was elected to the 8th and to the 3 seceding Congresses. He was an unsuccessful candidate for re-election in 1810 to the 12th Congress. Matthew Lyon was appointed United States factor to the Cherokee Nation in Arkansas Territory in 1820 and again attempted to serve in Washington, D.C. when he unsuccessfully contested the election of James W. Bates as a delegate from the Arkansas Territory to the 17th Congress. Matthew Lyon died in Spaldra Bluff, Arkansas, near Clarksville on August 1st, 1822. He was initially interred in Spaldra Bluff Cemetery in 1833. He was reinterred in Eddyville Cemetery in Eddyville, Kentucky. So that's Matthew Lyon, right? So he's this, you know, free speech martyr. He stood up to the Alien and Sedition Acts. He was imprisoned for about 4 months because of it and had about $1,000 worth of jail cost. There's the best defense against libel is the truth. There is that one German that went to trial over at Zinger, John Peter Zinger. So Matthew Lyon, you know, the Green Mountain Boys came and was going to destroy the jail he was in because he had fought with a later regiment of the Green Mountain Boys. So he had been in the, you know, part of that crew for about a year. He's a revolutionary. He's an Irish man. He comes into America. He fights for the Americans against the English. And, you know, and then he was a representative for many years. He was a career politician. Right. So then he has a grandson. So Matthew Lyon's grandson turned out to be completely off Lyon brand. Brigadier General Highland Benton Lyon rode with the fucking Confederates, okay? So he's this fucking racist for about 10,000 slave owners. He's willing to put his life down. He's riding with Robert E. Lee, Stonewall Jackson, Jeb Stuart, Nathan Bedford Forrest, who's the founder of the first Ku Klux Klan, Henry Watterson, the founder of the Courier Journal, Patrick Cleburne, Joe Wheeler, and Edmund Kirby Smith. Halen Benton Lyon was born February 22nd, 1836, in the part of Caldwell County in western Kentucky that later became Lyon County. He was a member of an influential and prominent family in western Kentucky, his grandfather being Matthew Lyon, pioneer settler from Vermont to western Kentucky. Highland Benton Lyon was living in a new county that was formed from a portion of Caldwell County and named Lyon County, western Kentucky, for a member of Highland Benton Lyon's family. After attending college, Highland Benton Lyon enrolled in the United States Military Academy, and Highland Benton Lyon received an appointment to the United States Military Academy at West Point in 1852 and graduated in 1856 with the rank of second lieutenant. However, he resigned his office in the U.S. Army when the Civil War broke out as he did not want to fight against the South, just like that other piece of shit, Beriah Magoffin. After almost 5 years of service in the U.S. military, he was posted from Florida to Montana. He resigned April 30th, 1861, so he could enter into the Confederacy. He raised Company F, 3rd Kentucky Infantry, the Confederate States of America. In January 1862, he was promoted to Lieutenant Colonel of the 8th Kentucky Infantry. Highland Benton Lyon murdered loyal Americans at Fort Donelson. While withdrawn from the area, Highland Benton Lyon was captured by Union forces. Highland Benton Lyon was imprisoned for almost 7 months, the majority of which was at Johnson's Island, before he was exchanged for 2 Confederate-held prisoners in August.
Mm-hmm.
think it's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. I just can't move.
How many? That's weird that there's only 1,200. There's 1,220.
Is that how many inmates are there?
That's what they said.
We were talking about that earlier. I didn't know how many were there.